Welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. I'm the RPG chick. We need to head back to Copper Lane. What are we doing at Copper Lane? I'd had a few places. We're not going to Twin Elms yet. We're not going to Anslog's Compass yet. Wherever those are, Lighthouse is soon. Talk to Cyril, we did that. We need to head back to Thristwin at Brackenbury Inn. Hall of Revealed Mysteries. Right, the Animancer in the Brackenbury Sanitarium. She needs the theorems of Pandgram to continue her research, but the archivist won't grant give her access. So for some reason, we're going to try to help her with that. And off we go. So yeah, I just want to get some of these miscellaneous quests out of the way. Before we head back to the lighthouse, and then we move over into Heritage Hill, finally. Few odds and ends to do in town here. We need to talk to Grimda. Although I wonder if Fexa would have anything to say on the matter.
Hail, traveler.
Nope. Oh, we can't. Oh, that's her. Oh. For some reason, it seemed longer before. All right.
Hello.
Grimda glances down her spectacles. Ever inquisitive, I see. An animancer named Nedin asked me to retrieve the theorems of Pandgram from the Elder Archives. What was that? Dun-dun-dun. Grimda's impressive frown deepens. Thank you for letting me know. I'll be sure to tuck that tome away from prying eyes and see that this Nedin never sets foot in here again. I was just trying to help. And I sealed it. In the meantime, here, a token of our appreciation. Ganna says, is this what we wanted? To see her barred entirely? It seems a fearsome price to pay. Knowledge dangled just out of reach makes a tempting prize for any soul. What else do you need? That sucks. I informed Grimda of Nedin's interest in the theories of Pandgram. Grimda thanked me for warning her and has taken measures to protect the book from any further attempts. She rewarded me for my honesty. Minor adventure completed. Firebrand returns to Stronghold with money. Spoils await in the Great Hall. Treasury chest. Awesome. Way to go, Firebrand. I don't know if there's a possibility of people dying in that on these quests. I think this is where you want to go, but it's guarded.
I can do that.
All right. The letters of Agmundur the Wise. I'm not normally one to condone theft, Theodas, but... Alright, not all of us can get through. Well, they're attacking us now. What do we got here for her? Zealous focus. Flames of devotion. Yeah, run back here and buff us. I have a feeling I might be starting over with this stuff here. Okay, Loth, that's enough with that.
Sure.
Is that going to stop anytime soon?
Hello? Hello?
What is this? Zealous focus. Scroll of Valor, Scroll of Defense. Animancy in the modern age. The queen that was and still is. Life and discoveries of Pandgram. This is what she wanted. Mention the name Pandgram to anyone with even a passing knowledge of animancy, and you could find yourself in for a very long discussion. Publicly reviled, but privately lauded as a hero and genius, Pangram's history is at turns revolutionary, horrific, and mysterious. Pandgram was fascinated, some might say obsessed, with the concept of animancy. It consumed his life as he dedicated everything to understand it. He would frequently travel to Eoglanfath and the Deerwood to visit the Angwithin ruins. There he would take notes and make sketches, bringing anything back with him that he could to help him unlock the mysteries. After years of study, Pandgram had reached the point where he could no longer conduct research on his own, and he took on an assistant, Helig of Thane. Soon, Helig was making trips to Eoglanfath in Pangram's stead, gathering knowledge while Pandgram stayed behind to experiment. This partnership quickly bore fruit, and Pandgram made a breakthrough, one that would irrevocably change his life and the general attitude about animancy forever. While the specifics of his experimentation will never be truly known, the rumors and stories that still circulate tell that he had sent out inquiries asking for live subjects to help with a dangerous experiment that might change their life, or might end it. Those who were already dying were especially encouraged to apply. Response was overwhelming, and Pandgram had his pick of numerous willing bodies. That is when he had his breakthrough. He discovered a way to fix a soul, anchoring it to its body so it couldn't leave at death. He had discovered eternal life. His research and life's work had resulted in the greatest single discovery that animancy could hope for. His findings were published and quickly spread through Valia and beyond, while some groups, the Wodican Church, actually, for example, decried his work as nothing more than blasphemy and heresy. Many put it to practice. Everyone wanted the chance at immortality. But everything comes with a cost. It quickly became apparent that simply restraining the soul while keeping the person technically alive was doing nothing for the body, which continued to decay, devolving and warping the soul now trapped inside it. The creatures it created were dangerous, carnivorous beasts that killed brutally and indiscriminately. The backlash was ruthless. The practice of Pangram's discoveries was outlawed. His works were collected and burned. He and Helig were branded heretics and hunted, chased from town to town until Pangram simply vanished. Wonder if there's any chance we'll come across him. And I'm wondering if we'll have to fight the rest of this entire place. There's quite a lot of them in here. And I don't want the whole city after me, too. So if the whole city is after me, I might have to reload, guys. Helig was tracked down, captured, and brought to trial for the atrocities committed against Valia and its people. The trial was barely more than a formality to bring charges against him, as everyone knew what hand he had played in the disaster. He was sent to prison for years, but eventually released once public outrage died down. Not long after his parole, he disappeared as well. Occasionally, talk surfaces that a copy of Pangram's theorems have been found. Right, this is just about Pangram. We want the theorems. Untouched by the purging flames that destroyed its brothers. These rumors seldom end up being more than that. Many groups and wealthy individuals have formed sending out a call to anyone who will listen. Find us a copy of the theorems. They offer gold, jewels, status, anything they can to entice adventurers to help them achieve their goals. For there are those who would give anything a chance at immortality, even become a monster. We've got some other books here. Not sure if I have Animancy in the Modern Age and the Queen. I'm pretty sure we don't have the Queen book. I don't know if I should even read these, because we might reload after this. Anything about Animancy? And it's a brownish book, right? Sorry about that. This is going to be my final episode with this, this headset. I'm going to be exchanging it for a new one. At least Alos stopped doing that. It's a brownish book. I read something about Animancy. I just don't remember exactly what. Okay, I guess we're reading these. Animancy in the Modern Age. Animancy is a science both respected and reviled, sometimes by the same person. For all the research done on the topic, we still know so little. Control over life itself, something animancers have been working toward for hundreds of years. There are no real records as of how the practice of animancy was first discovered, but once the spark of knowledge ignited, there was no stopping its inevitable discoveries. In 2260 AI, animancers, as a result of their extensive research, successfully contained and transferred a soul. The subject of the experiment, whose name is unknown, was young and wealthy but infirm. The idea was to move a soul from the dying body and into that of a recently deceased man who had suffered an accident. The new body, bearing only slight decay, would house the soul, giving the man a much better life. The outcome of this experiment resulted in the condemnation and outlaw of animancy in the Adiran Empire. Again, while we have no true records of what happened, as they were all destroyed after animancy was outlawed, a journal was discovered, a makeshift confession by one of the participants. Excerpts from that journal follow. 2260 AI. Von Prima, 16. It is done, and the gods forgive us for our arrogance. I am not sure what I was expecting. Certainly not that, but what did any of us expect? Still, behind the revulsion there is a sense of pride, something I can't deny. All the research, the studying, everything we worked for. We thought we'd change the world. How it's changed. All was in place, the twisted form lying on the table next to its new vessel. The equipment had been prepared. The tinctures and potions all carefully crafted, every detail painstakingly organized to ensure success. We most assuredly succeeded. The procedure went exactly as it should. The soul, extracted from the old body, held, bound in place to prevent it from moving on. Then the next step, transfer to the fresh vessel. It was beautiful and terrifying. I listened as they spoke the words of binding. I watched the soul move, not the soul itself, of course, but the vapor we used to detect it, as it lowered into the vessel. A gentle luminescence covered the body, and then nothing. Silence. Darkness. I held my breath, afraid that even the slightest disturbance would destroy all our hard work. Then motion. Then, dear gods, then blood. How did I survive? I do not know. The vessel rose from the slab and the room breathed. Every person crowded around the tables exhaled. Some cheered. We had made life from death. We had become eternal. The body closed its eyes and tilted its head, looking for all purposes to be listening for something, or to it. Then its eyes popped open and it moved. Its lips peeled back from its teeth in a horrible expression of fury. It fell on the nearest man, tearing his throat, knocking him to the ground. Then the room erupted into screams, shouts, and a flurry of bodies running, pushing, doing everything in their power to get away from the creature sitting on their colleague. But right before that happened, in the split second before the chaos, when there was nothing in the air but a stunned, terrified silence, I heard it. Sitting there, on his chest, face at his neck, and it was feasting. The queen that was and still is. Dear sisters, do you remember your first deliverance, when you strangled your first wrongdoer? Did you see the moment of life become death? Could you see the instance when your victim realized that Whittaker forgets nothing? When Whittaker takes back her throne, will you face her with pride, knowing you have held to your own oaths, or will you be amongst the word-breakers? Whittaker teaches vengeance and memory, and while she is in exile, we must let her eyes and ears... We must be her eyes and ears, that no injustice slip from record. We must be the clenched fist that silences the lying breath. When Whittaker takes back her throne, all of the injustices that have slipped through the cracks of history will be righted. The villains hiding in plain sight amongst the innocent will feel the burned queen's choking grasp. Pray that you live to see the day when you will join our queen in this cleansing of the wicked. But know, my sisters, that we must be ready to see the end of our days without the return of our queen, for she will take back her throne, but it may be our daughters that serve the restored court. We must continue to live as we have always lived, hated by the other faiths, even though we place justice above our own well-being. At least the Empire of Adir still holds our creed in proper esteem. It is a proper sign of respect that, by imperial custom, our clergy must oversee a contract for it to be legally binding. For who else understands the value of remembering one's oaths than Whittaker's faithful? And let us not count our current blessings, for we still enjoy the support of the Paladin Order of the Steel Garrote? They too understand that society is built and broken by the oaths and rules of its people. When Whittaker takes back her throne, my family will know that I was right to commit my life to the exiled queen. When Whittaker takes back her throne, the Strangler will stop being a story told to frighten our daughters, but a hero woven into parables that teach our children justice. When Whittaker takes back her throne, she will bring her flawless memory with her. Every transgression, every crime, and every injustice will be revealed. When Whittaker takes back her throne, even gods won't be spared their due retribution. Well, who knows if such a moment will come to pass. Okay. We're going to be attacked now. Not sure if I sneak. I don't know if I can sneak out of here. There's no other way out. There's no back way out. And that'd be nice, wouldn't it? Now, just because these guys are after us... I mean, they're all over the freaking place. I don't know how we can escape them, really. Yeah, exactly. I'm gonna do amplified thrust off of Eater. Eater will do knockdown on this guy. Holy Radiance. Fireblade thingy. Whole place under attack. not doing a knockdown. He's almost dead. I can't believe this, guys. Soul Shock of Everdare. That's it. Oh, we're killing Fexa. Ooh, chunks. Attacking. They're actually being smart for once.
Of course.
Yeah.
Did we talk to this Janny person before? Keep up so we can cast this Holy Radiance. There might be others coming from behind now as well. Oh wait. Not lay on hands. God. We literally plowed through this guy. I thought she was attacking Canna for a sec, or whoever's over there. I dare. Our Defiance Bay went to Eccentric, faintly mixed. Are we wanted now? I'm swaying to see if we get attacked by everyone now.
Got it.
Okay. Yeah, I saw a Grim that keeps in the back. We've got it. But we don't have what she wants. We need to go to Brackenbury.
You must.
Hmm? You just start saying that? You must gather your party before venturing forth? I gotta hear that.
Following your lead.
I didn't know it said that. That's from Baldur's Gate.
Must gather your party before.
Haha. They cut him off.
Venturing forth.
Oh, there you go. Alright. We need to go talk to this guy. I think in here is where we were. I forget his name, but we'll see it in a sec. And then we need to head to the sanitarium. Talk to what's her name. As you can tell, I don't remember her names well. Just when. We did not recover your item.
Good day to you.
The fancy elf eyes you and your pack. Did you do it? Did you get the medallion from Cyril? She wouldn't give it to us. Who's this standing here? It sounds like she's worked hard and been fair with you. I won't help you cheat her. He clenches his fist over the edges of his silken sleeves. I don't want to. I'd give her everything else I have. I just want to help my clan. Don't want to what? She wouldn't give it to us. I'll deal with you later.
Good day to you.
Whatever. I'm not gonna attack him and kill him over it. We don't owe any allegiance to the Cyril. We paid 1,000 frickin' copper and, for nothing. Well, for sex, but we didn't even get to see it. We need to go to the sanitarium. Who was it again? She's down there, right? She's down below. Main quest. I forget who it was. Wasn't she? There was someone standing outside who wanted help. Hold on. And I guess the quest is technically done. I guess she. Maybe she was standing outside here and she moved down below. I don't know. We'll find her. Maybe. We'll look for her. That's what I'm saying. That's all I can say. Is it Verna? I'm not sure if I've read her story already, but I'm not going to now. Is it Yarmid? Let's go down below. I do remember talking to this lady in a cell right down there. Seems like a cell anyway, but it's a room. It has a cage in it. So, at first I thought that was her, but something made me doubt that, but maybe it is after all. I guess I got spooked in this place. Bellisage? Huh. Maybe it's not her.
Good day, stranger.
Some view it as eccentric, it seems. Alright, she's not down here. Nans?
Gods keep you.
An elderly woman peruses the shelves with a quickness and energy that belie her age. I'm afraid I don't practice anymore, child. Too busy with my research. I see, I haven't talked to her. Did we ever go in this room before? Or did I miss it? What do you do here? I'm an animancer, used to venture on all kinds of underfunded and ill-fated trips out of the expedition hall when I was your age, but lately I've found research better suited to my current pace. She pats a creaking knee and laughs. She regards you with bright, intelligent eyes. Can I help you with anything else? I'd like to know more about the Sanitarium. It's the official center of animancy in Defiance Bay, founded in 2729, and before you get saucy, no, I wasn't around at the time. It was built to treat ailments of the mind and soul, important sort of place to have in a growing city, and its construction marked the end of the animancy slowdown that followed the Bailreach accident. Bailreach accident? She shakes her head. A terrible setback for the discipline. A researcher working outside the Bail Marsh shattered the souls of a dozen volunteers. Her voice lowers to a growl. Of course, we'll never know exactly what went wrong because the mob tore him to pieces. This mishap bears some of the blame for the slower pace of research in the 2.5 decades that followed, but it also helped concentrate practicing animancers here in Defiance Bay. Imatil sent me. He said you'd be interested in those scepter pieces we found, right? That chatty old fishwife's been babbling on about me, I see. She laughs and rolls her eyes. Never trust your secrets to a man with so much salt in his beard. Anyway, let's see what you've got. She examines the scepter, her eyes hooded by crinkled flesh. Imatil told you true. I'll buy this. Unfortunately, a broken scepter isn't as valuable as he may have led you to believe. She steals a glance at your face, but her fingers tighten around the piece in her hands. I'll take it off you for 500. I'll use my lore. Nonsense. This could easily be repaired by someone with the proper skills. Her eyes flash under their sagging lids. I've got the skills, all right, and you know more than the average relic hunter, I see. Making it whole again is a matter of alchemy, expensive alchemy. I've got to soak the broken ends in a fiend's blood compound to reconnect them. Fiend's blood compound. Never mind the embalming work to restore the enchantments. She eyes you. I could do it to the tune of 1,800 pans. Sure. Put the scepter back together. Here. I expect you'll want to watch and see that your money's put to good use. Better get comfortable, then. She lays out an array of powders, potions, and other obscure ingredients on her desk. After what feels like hours, she returns to the main hall with you and presents the scepter. Looking at it, you'd never know it had been broken in the first place. This may be the finest work I've ever done, if I may say so. And thank you for giving me the opportunity. Examining a piece like that is a dream come true for someone in my field. She gazes at it wistfully. Take good care of it. Farewell. Addendum added. Clandestine cargo. Complete task. Oh, we need to find a missing crate. Alright, so we've got the scepter. Someone's got the scepter. Ooh. Inguithan's scepter. This Inguithan weapon was restored from fragments you found in Ondra's gift. The shaft is covered with invocations and the opal finial inscribed with runes. For Aloth? /17 crush slash versus deflection. Speed. +20% attack speed, I guess, is the main difference. Or the only difference. Okay. He'll use that. Nice. Enjoy, Aloth.
Hello.
It's not him. Who was it we were talking to, and where is she? It was the one outside. I can't find the quest now. I guess it's done. Nedin. Met her in front. We can't even tell her what happened. And I broke in there to get it anyway. There was nothing. Doesn't say anything. We're gonna find her or anything, does it? Wait, it's in here, right? Where was it again? It was considered done. Gotta be in there too. Maybe we'll go back and see. Maybe we need to search for a hidden door in that room. Alright, thanks for watching, everyone. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.